Sorry if I seem a little off. I am kind of tired at the moment. Was louder than I expected it. There we go. Hopefully I'm getting this correct. Yep. So what I'm doing here is, like every other selection, I am making the inputs for selecting and deselecting, or for getting into and out of this menu. Expecting. All right, I have to actually make the this part. There we go. So, reason why I've been working on the menu so much is because I don't want to write any net code at the moment because I'm trying to learn how to do Winsock programming. So that I can make my game better. Because currently, to connect to a hosted game, what one has to do is they have to find someone to host the game. Someone in each friend group is probably going to be the guy who knows how to host. But then, for this particular game, because of how GDevelop works, like sometimes its IDE crashes. I don't know why. In any case, because of how it works, it requires port forwarding both on the person who's hosting's side, which, I mean, that's true for any server, but also requires port forwarding for each of the clients, which is not wanted. But if I can learn how to do programming for Windows sockets, then actually I should hold off on saving until I confirm that. Subselect. Right, so once I learn how to do programming with Windows sockets, I'll be good to go to write. Well, one, I'll be able to write the networking code for that just directly in C++. Or for this for in C++. Which will mean that I can remove the requirement that everyone has to port forward and more just offload this onto just one person who knows how to port forward. But even if, right, no one in your friend group knows how to port forward, I will be able to make my own server software. Which means that you might not have to. Did I just we're getting rid of that? All right, so Subselection is one. That would be for a split screen game. Subselection is two. That would be for a network game. Okay. Now, ideally, I would just write this, I would write MBI in C++ directly. However, making windows and drawing windows to screen is where I find the new point of unapproachability. Because I tried it, and what I do works okay for like 5 minutes. And I mean, like, I write a very basic program to create a bitmap to display to the screen. And I want this bitmap to kind of rock back and forth in a somewhat sine wave pattern. Okay, that works fine. Except, like, 5 minutes later when it decides that, that doesn't work. Instead, what you get 5 minutes during the program runtime is just a black screen. Now, I might be doing something wrong. In fact, I am almost certain that I am, because this doesn't seem to be a bit of a problem for anyone else. But I cannot understand what I'm doing wrong. And that's why my current goal is just to get to the point where I can write Winsock. Okay, so number three would be the tutorial. So once you're here, one additional confirm, and I am going to make this only able to be confirmed with Control 3. Then I mean, I had the feeling that I really should be writing a separate tutorial level for all of the characters. Just so that way I can make sure that the tutorial covers the ability of the character. But I suppose for now, the other thing I'm doing currently is making MBI more accessible with a split screen multiplayer. So you don't necessarily have to be on the same network to not port forward. You can be at the same computer, assuming you have multiple ways of interfacing with the game. Let's see. Split screen. Let's see, does this work? Maybe I just got the wrong one. I got the wrong one. But why is that the wrong one? Did I just... Yeah, I don't know what's going on. That might be what's going on. It's 10:59. Well, for me, later when I upload this to YouTube, I started the stream at 10:30. Wait a minute. Maybe I didn't need to do that. Maybe it didn't save the fact that I did. Again. I realized my mistake, like one step after, I should have opened the autosave. But since I've opened this, I believe the autosave happens immediately, and thus it's pointless to try to save what's not there anymore. Okay, so. What? We'll close these two. Close this. Gonna try to remember what I was doing. Right, so actually I should probably load the settings at some point. Some timer. Oh. Actually, I'm just gonna copy that, paste it here. If I remember correctly, I've changed this around slightly, so. You know what? This is good. variables I am looking for. Volume master, volume music, volume phone, volume effects, and volume environment. Something tells me that I shouldn't be able to do this. Something tells me that I should be more required to do something like... that. Let me double check this. All right. Let me double check the spelling. I'm not entirely sure if that's spelled correctly. Yeah, I thought there was an N in there. Also, just before, like, something wonky happens, I'm going to, take this and change it up a little bit. I will still have to go in, but at least my job will be a little easier. Mm-hmm. does. Oh, right. Well, this is a simple fix. That should be all. Okay, so now that I have written these things in, so master music, phone, effects, and environment in that order, I will now have to load them. I really should use a static variable here. Let's see. MMF result equals G develop string from locale, which just basically converts between a standard string and a G develop string. Main get stored string, which main is this. Seeing the variables. Selector number and part. Stored string and what is that down here? There we go. I have a feeling that this code here is even more held together by duct tape and wishful thinking than my code in here. Written this quite a while ago. I can't remember too much about what everything is supposed to do. All right, if we're not at the end of the file, and flag is three. or is less than 3, then if the character we get is that, then flag will be 1, length will be 0, carry dot length will be 0. Else, if it's not a comma and the flag is 1, then we insert the character into the carry. Hold on, what is the what? What even is this? Like defined. Okay, it's defined here. I'm not entirely sure why I have a statistics class when I'm not using it, but maybe I am somewhere. So, selector equals carry. No, it's not I, then it just iterates. But if it is, then flag 2. I mean, okay. I'm not entirely sure why it isn't also checking for a. Wait, hold on. If this is the input character, right? No matter what the flag is, it will set it to 1. If this is the input character and the flag is 1, then hold up. Does this even work? Oh wait, hold on. This is not the right thing. This is the right thing. I've been spending a lot of time looking at the wrong thing. And man, do I not want to go through this. I'm just going to trust that that one works. Zero-based? I have to go through that. Ooh. You know what? I'll see if it works. So I don't want to go through that. Really don't want to go through that. Yeah, I cut it off at 20 characters long. In any case. Wait, why do I have this here? Okay, well, Does this work? I can already tell it's wrong. Simple as that. Hopefully it is. Hopefully. I can see it took one value. Let's see. There's no way I'm going to understand what I've written there. So I gotta just carefully re-look at my work. Result equals main get short string selector number and part. When does the flag start to equal one? It's hold on. Flag is zero here. Okay, I don't know how, but I think these might actually need to be on the same level. Okay. Turn empty. Turn empty. What? Let's see. None of the others do that. What about in file loader? No, there's nothing there. Functions, current task. Okay. Build map. Where? Okay, so apparently I've been doing this entire thing wrong. Two. Three. And this is supposed to be easy. I don't know how. I don't know how. But if this works, well, I'm not going to be exactly the happiest person in the world that. We'll see. We will see. Loading that way because it is that way, or is it loading that way because some error happened? Commas, and that's supposed to break these things up. This last one's a zero. This has me confused. Okay. Why? File name thing, read part, the iterator, a magic number, and yeah, another magic number, but it's zero. Now, I don't iterate here because there's nothing next. There's no next entry. Maybe it has to be one. Maybe when it's zero, it messes up somehow. I mean, you need to get a drink. If I put in a 1, it doesn't matter. Why? Is it something down here that I forgot? Yes, it is. Okay, now I fixed one bug. Actually, two. It's just one of these didn't necessarily propagate. So, hopefully, it should work. Something is wrong. Master and music are the same. They should not be. Telephony is zero, which should be what music is set to. Effects is 100. And environment is 60. I think it starts with one. Okay, 79, 0, 100, 60, and 42. All right, we have loading. Finally, it works. Oh my. That was a lot of running around for something that was a simple fix, just flying right under my nose. Is the next thing I should. So, absolutely ill-advised, but you could do that. The big question is, will it save? Indeed. Alright. It is getting pretty late. I am going to call it here. So, to everyone except for the one person who was advertising in chat, which was the only person who messaged in chat, to everyone else, thank you. That will be it for me to die. Not to die. That will be it for me today. Auf Wiedersehen.